back from that quick break. You're still watching Urban Television, and my name is Anisha with a tea right here on Living. Cab Kisementi is the place that we chill at, by the way. Thank you very much for giving us the space. And I'm still here with Esther, and in the first 10 minutes, we're tackling domestic violence in children. We talked about the differences. That is, it's not only physical, but it can also be psychological. We also talked about some of the causes, and this one of stepmothers really had me like, banange. Because, you know, like I said, as we're growing up, Nigerian movies.
Yeah.
Who's that? What, you know that Nigerian actor, the famous one?
Yeah.
Patience. Patience, wherever you are. She was the queen. If you see her in a movie, you know it's going to be a torture kind of, you know. But I think times have evolved. People have changed. People now these days, they don't just get married.
Saying if you love the man, love the children. Yeah, it has helped.
But also men don't just, you know, not that women don't, but men, after the wife dies, 2 years down the road, you already want another
wife. You don't have time to bond with your children.
Yes, and I had a friend of mine called Sharon, and her father raised his daughters. He raised them. Yes, he had his other women, but they were never allowed to come. He had his family house. Like when you give birth, he was the parent. He did it all by himself, and his children have turned out just right. Unfortunately, that goes out for you. The men are the ones who usually, you know, go under these situations, because they're the ones who rush to get married because they're like, my child needs a mother. Then their child ends up getting a stepmother. But it's about who is what? Anyway, it's about that time we get into plus size. Now, most times on the show, I have models, and they're tall, they're slender, they're 6+. But today we have a plus size lady who is pushing for plus size models. Tell us, where did this passion come in from?
I grew up loving modeling. I've loved modeling since I was a child. So as tiny, but then as I was growing up, I gained weight, but still I loved modeling. So I started going for auditions, and sometimes they would push you away. Some would just allow you, just for the sake, but they used to push me away sometimes. So I felt bad, and I felt like there are girls like me that love modeling, but they're big. So I thought, that's how I thought about it. I thought I should start a campaign. And I've always gone for things that have a purpose. I'm a beauty queen because I went through Miss Social Media and I was second runners-up.
When was this campaign, Miss Social Media?
2016, yeah.
But you see the problem with this, with the modeling industry, even before we get into the plus size bit of it, you don't push out there. You get models who come here and they're like, please help us. They tell you, when I went to Nigeria, I was alone. Other people had people supporting them. I only had one gown. So that itself.
I don't believe in that. Me, I always push what I want. That's why I pushed it hard. If I fail to go through the other audition, let me do it myself, because I'll not wait for the rest. Yeah, I'll do it myself. I would go for maybe, I went for a show and I just had one attire, but I was happy. I was glad, I was happy. It's actually Helen Nkoma that gave me the chance to be on her runway. So I felt happy. Since then, I said I should do this. I might be alone, but I'll do it.
So how far, tell us, how far? People helping you, people being positive? Because, well, like I told you, when people think of modeling, they think of skinny. Yeah, let me tell you something. When I was young, people used to ask me, what do you want to be? I would say two things. Either I wanted to be a mother, which I have achieved, or I'll say I want to be a model, but I'm short. Yeah. You get it? So many of us we have to take, you know, be like, this is my dream, but I can't do that because of my physical appearance.
I don't believe in that, because I have girls, I have models that are with me in the campaign, but some of them are short, actually. But because they love what they do, that's why they brought heels. So I think they can put on
heels. That's why you have heels.
So I believe height doesn't matter. Even those other countries, they also have short models. Yeah, so I have big short models. And I have actually also small models, because I want people to believe it's not about size.
But then, you see, let me give you an example. If you say if it's not about size, people say, okay, then to be an engineer, it's not about brains. Just because I want to be an engineer, I'll be an engineer. That's how you're killing the fact that even modeling has its what? has its benchmarks that you have to be a certain kind of this. You get it? So just because I want to be a doctor, does that, oh, I'd love to be a doctor, but you're not smart enough, but you're not tall enough to, you understand? Don't you feel like everything has its benchmark if you can't qualify?
I'm dealing with these girls. I tell them you need to have passion for what you're doing. After passion, we go through maybe trainings and all those things. Of course, someone who loves something, you just see they love it, they'll do it. Even if they're short, even if they'll do it. That's why we have runways of albinos, runways of people that are lame. Yeah, they also have fashion shows. So I believe if you love something, you can do it. Because modeling is employment. Why are they leaving out the big girls and yet they can also join?
Is this your dream? Are you planning to push this, work on it? Are you trying to put up a modeling agency? Or is it going to be a short-lived thing, like I'm just doing a campaign and then I'm done?
No.
What are the future?
My plans now,
I'm doing a campaign first so that people know about it. A campaign will take like a few months, like 6 months, photo shoots and videos and all those. Then we're going to be having this annual show of the Charity Plus Size campaign. Its cause is to help sensitize teenagers about the dangers of teenage pregnancy in schools and in our communities. Yes. So that's going to be every year. That's going to happen every year. And then we also have to start up, we're planning on Miss Plus Size Uganda. Like Miss Uganda, but this is Miss Plus.
Miss Plus Size Uganda. And it's all you. You're the founder. Do you have anyone who's helping you push it?
Right now, nobody, because people haven't believed in it yet. But I believe in it because the show, the last show was successful. We didn't have a lot of people, but yeah, people are there. People believed in it. People loved it. Every time I tell someone like you, Anisha, this is a, they say, wow, I've never heard about this. But in other countries, it's happening.
What about your family? Because they say when your family comes in, most times things.
Yeah, of course, family. Family is supporting me so much.
Okay, yeah. My dear, so when is this going to take place? We have to know so we can support your young lady. How are you balancing this with school? Because I'm sure you're in school.
I'm done with school.
Oh, you look like a baby.
I'm done with school, yeah. But I'm working, and the little funds that I get, the little money that I get is what I use.
That is very beautiful, because today I was reading a quote from Kenyatta, and he said, if you love your children, start a business for them. Don't get a job, because if you get that job and you die, they'll replace you. But what will your children have? So are you planning to also keep this for your future, for the future? Like, for example, it's going to be your side hustle. Your children can take this up. You have like a new modeling agency. 10 years from now, we're looking at it. Because you're putting your funds there.
Yeah,
so it seems like a business to me.
It's not a business. First of all, I'm doing this, like, more of a company. I did this. I first put emotions when I was starting it. Yeah. So I said, whatever it takes, I'll do. Yeah. I didn't think about the other side of business. I thought about, even doing the show, I didn't think about business. I always do something with a purpose. That's why I joined Mr. Shemde, because their cause was to help maternal mothers and all those things, yes. So I don't look at it as a family thing. Yeah. I can have someone who will handle maybe a personal assistant or something.
Not your children.
My children should also have something they want.
This was leading to a question.
Yeah.
Are you planning to set up a family?
Yeah, no. They should also have something they love.
Okay. Mm. Thank you very much, Esther, for being part of the show. Actually, it's going to take part next year in May, but you're already pushing for it, so that's beautiful. So maybe in May we'll be hearing some big poster out there with sponsors, and they'll be, you know, pushing for plus size models, because that's a beautiful cause. Thank you very much for talking about domestic violence in children. People, be aware that your children are not going through this. You know, like we said, I'm going to emphasize this. It could be physical, but it could also be psychological through the words you tell them, the way you raise them. Things like, you see children who are being starved. So go back home, think about it, whether you are a parent or not. It could be the person who is next door, a neighbor's child who is going through.
The right to report. Some neighbors just look at it and siwange.
Neda, a community raises a child. Siwo. But you don't know, you understand. So at the end of the day, a community raises a child. That is all we had for you. Beautiful Tuesday to everyone. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.